have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue just thinking about you. Decorations are red on a green Christmas tree. Won't be the same, dear, if you're not here with me. And when those blue snowflakes stop falling, that's when those blue heartaches start calling. You'll be doing all right with your Christmas a while, but I'll have a blue, blue Christmas. Yes, I'll have a blue, blue, blue Christmas.
Thank you. Please join me in the call to worship. This is the night we have waited for. It is the most beautiful night of the year. It is the night of shepherds and stables and of humble people everywhere. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth.
Because God so loves the world,
this beautiful and broken world,
this divided and distanced and world,
this warming and burning world,
this lost and hurting world.
God's love is made flesh.
For such a time as this,
a child is born unto us.
For such a time as this,
the light of Christ shines upon us.
In a stinky stable turned birthing room,
new visions of family and community are born.
By the surprising subversion of God's unbreaking love,
the burden of injustice is thrown off.
Through the ages-old song of angels and shepherds,
God's glory is proclaimed.
On this holy night, the one we've been watching for is here.
On this holy night, the time we've been waiting for is now.
Let us rejoice together.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace and goodwill to all.
For such a time as this, the Christ child comes to us. For such a time as this, God's love is born in us. Joy to the world.
Fall on your knees, oh. Christ was born. Oh, night divine, oh, night divine.
The Annunciation, Luke chapter 1:20-31. In the 6th month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and the angel came to her and said, "Greeting, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by these words, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and you will now conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus."
Chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world would be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was the governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph went from town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and he was expecting a child. While they were there, the time for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to the firstborn son, and wrapped him in bandage cloth, and laid him in the manger, because there was no place for him in the inn.
Gathered all above. The Shepherds, Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 14. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom God favors."
Was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay, in fields where they keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep. Noel, Noel, Noel. And saw a star shining in the east beyond them far, and to the earth it gave a great light, and so it continued both day and night. No.
When the angels had left the shepherds and gone into heaven, they said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child laying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as had been told them.
The Magi, Matthew chapter 2, verses 2 through 11. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, Magi from the east came from Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born king of the Jews? For we observe his star at its rising, and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem was with him, and calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" The Herod secretly called for the Magi and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I can also go and pay him homage." When we heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and knelt down to pay him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts we travel afar, feeling fountain, moor, and mountain, follow.
Frankincense to offer have I, incense owns a deity nigh, prayer and praising, all men rising, and let me tell you, all men are raising this frankincense. You can't find it anywhere. You can't find it anywhere. He knows it, she knows it, the little baby over there knows it, everyone knows it. You wind it up and it really gets it going. It's great. That really what gets them to worship them God on high.
Myrrh is mine, its bitter perfume breathes a life of gathering gloom, sorrowing, sighing, bleeding, dying, sealed in a stone cold tomb.
For a key on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again. Things forever, ceasing never, over us all to reign.
Oh, stop.
Magi brought gifts to the Christ child to honor him. We invite you to present your own gifts at our virtual manger by giving to those who have little. Please either send a check to First Congregational Church, 10 West Lockwood Avenue, Webster Groves, Missouri 63119, with the word manger in the memo line, or go to our website's donate page and give electronically. All gifts from the manger go to Gateway 180 Homeless Services. I invite you to pray with us the prayer of dedication. Good Christian friends, rejoice.
Let all the beloved of God rejoice.
All creation groaning, rejoice.
Everyone who has felt beaten down or alone, rejoice.
Heaven and earth, rejoice. Jesus, our Savior, is born today. Christ, our Lord, was born for this. Love our light shines brightly through our gifts. May our offerings by God's blessing become hope renewed and life restored. Amen.
Let us pray. When the world was dark and the city was quiet, you came. You crept in beside us. And no one knew. Only the few who dared to believe that God might do something different. Will you do the same this Christmas, Lord? Will you come into the darkness of today's world, not the friendly darkness, as when sleep rescues us from tiredness, but the fearful darkness in which people have stopped believing that war will end, or that food will come, or that a government will change, or that the church cares. Will you come into that darkness and do something different? to save your people from death and despair? Will you come into the quietness of this city? Not the friendly quietness as when lovers hold hands, but the fearful silence when the phone has not rung, the letter has not come, the friendly voice no longer speaks, the doctor's face says it all. Will you come into that darkness and do something different, not to distract, but to embrace your people? And will you come into the dark corners and the quiet places of our lives? We ask this not because we're guilt-ridden or want to be, but because the fullness our lives long for depends on us being as open and as vulnerable to you as you were to us when you came, wearing no more than a diaper and trusting human hands to hold their maker. Will you come into our lives if we open them to you and do something different? When the world was dark and the city was quiet, you came. You crept in beside us. Do the same this Christmas, Lord. Do the same this Christmas. Amen.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night, star.
Thank you for joining us on Christmas Eve. We hope you've been blessed by our worship. Go in peace. Merry Christmas.
Next year on, our troubles will be out of sight. Once again, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough.